In the years following 2011, it has been nothing but a downhill struggle for the European giant AC Milan. Due to their financial troubles, AC Milan was forced to become a selling club. They tried to replace players like Ricardo Kaká, Zlatan Ibrahimovic, Thiago Silva, Andrea Pirlo, Seedorf, Gattuso, Nesta with average loanies and an array of underperforming players. Even when they tried to spend big in 2017, it didn't work out. Lately though, since the beginning of 2020, the arrival of Zlatan Ibrahimovic and Stefano Pioli on the sidelines has completely turned the tables, and the Rossoneri fans can finally see some light at the end of a long and dark tunnel. So in celebration of this light and Milan's current form, let's look at their 10 best free kicks between the years 2000 and 2010. We first travel back to the season 2000-2001, which was somewhat of a mess for the Rossoneri. Owner and President Silvio Berlusconi was on his campaign to become the Italian Prime Minister. Cesare Maldini became caretaker of the club, and a disappointing Serie A campaign made the season easy to write off for all Milan fans. The Milan derby, though, was anything but a disappointment. The choreography before kickoff in the Curva Sud had the Diavola throttling a blue and black snake, the symbol of Inter Merda. After 90 minutes, this choreography would prove to be prescient. Inter were 2-0 down at the end of the first half, and it didn't get any better when Federico Giunti scored this free kick to make it 3, which evaded everyone in the box and managed to sneak past Sebastian Frey. At the sixth goal, the cameras cut to Inter's coach Marco Tardelli mouthing the words, "Mamma mia." Mamma mia indeed, 3 more goals and the Rossoneri made a record for the biggest margin of victory in the Derby della Madonnina ever, a record that still holds till this day. The Curva Sud still often sing about it. Forza Milan. Number 9 and 8 is the time frame when young Rossoneri found out that he was a Milanisti. Andrea Pirlo and Clarence Seedorf were Milan's focal point in the midfield for many years, orchestrating the midfield and attack and creating incredible chances for their teammates with surgically precise passing, breaking down play, and elegant dribbling. The 2006 and 7 season had its ups and downs for Milan. Having started the season with an 8-point penalty due to the Calciopoli scandal, Milan's run in the Champions League was a completely different story. Overcoming Celtic in the round of 16, Bayern Munich in the quarterfinals, Manchester United in the semifinals, and finally Liverpool in the final, the Ragazzi avenged the nightmare of Istanbul. Campione di Europa! That last Champions League trophy was very special, and among the many highlights was Ricardo Kaká and his brilliant form, scoring 10 goals in 12 matches and winning that year's Champions League Golden Boot, and later the prestigious Ballon d'Or. This award since then has only been won by Lionel Messi and Cristiano Ronaldo. We're just gonna ignore Luka Modric for argument's sake. The maestro once again at number 7. Although this free kick was great, this scoreline and Pirlo remind us of another great goal, another screamer against Parma in October of 2010, a goal that even had Ronaldinho in awe. Sheva, sheva, sheva. One of our 6 Ballon d'Or winners and our 2nd most prolific goal scorer with 175 goals, second only to the great Gunnar Nordahl. Associazione Calcio Milan began the 2004-2005 season auspiciously by winning the 2004 Supercoppa Italiana, with a comfortable 3-0 victory over Lazio, the reigning champs, thanks to a hat-trick by Andrei Shevchenko. We were 2nd in the Serie A that season, only behind Juventus, who in those days had a very romantic relation with the Italian Federation referees. That year, Shevchenko, who had scored the deciding penalty 2 years early, had to score the fifth penalty to keep Milan in the game, for us to have at least one more shot, but failed to. We do not talk about that Champions League final! Milan paid 43 million euros for that free kick, and in doing so, Manuel Rui Costa became Milan's most expensive transfer of all time. He played 5 seasons in the red and black jersey and pretty much won it all with us. One of the biggest surprises of this season was that a certain Brazilian trequartista seemingly found his way into the Italian game, being a key player in Milan's success. Following Kaká's arrival, Rui Costa's game time at the San Siro slowly started diminishing. As winners of the 2006-2007 UEFA Champions League, Milan competed in the UEFA Super Cup and the FIFA Club World Cup, winning both competitions under the orchestration of Carlo Ancelotti. For the tifosi who dislike Andrea Pirlo, please bear with me. The maestro had absolutely no right to score from that angle. After spending 10 years at Milan and having his most goals and appearances for us, Andrea Pirlo has since become an awkward topic for the Milan fans. He made several controversial comments about Milan in his autobiography that came out in 2013. In the first chapter, he reveals why he decided to leave the club. He didn't want to play on the left of the midfield for coach Max Allegri. It is this situation that he describes in his beautiful and rather fitting words. Love him or hate him, he is an important and memorable part in our glorious history. Numero duo is my personal favorite one, the magnificent David Beckham. With his beautiful free kick, Beckham made a very good case for becoming a permanent part of the red and black San Siro outfit. Unfortunately, the universe had other ideas. From an extremely testing angle, he managed to hit a free kick that any dead ball specialist would have been proud of. Inch perfect and hit with tremendous velocity, the former England captain has shown that he is a master of the free kick, and that any teams playing against him made sure they didn't give away any cheap fouls near the box. His ACL injury was very, very unfortunate for us Milanisti, but him, Pirlo, and Ronaldinho standing behind the free kick is still one of the most haunting images for any goalkeeper in the world. David Beckham has always remembered Milan in great words, and our feelings towards him are very, very mutual. The only player to win the Champions League with 3 different teams, Clarence Seedorf has a very special place in the red and black hearts. The Netherlands schemer joined Internazionale in the year 2000, and 2 years later signed for the Nerazzurri's City rivals. He promptly lifted Europe's biggest prize in his first term with Milan. Clarence Seedorf shared the stage with the last known great Milan side, which included the likes of Nelson Dida, Alessandro Nesta, Paolo Maldini, Massimo Ambrosini, Riccardo Kaká, Gennaro Gattuso, among many others. It's important to note that he had one of the best runs as Milan manager in the banter era. Who knows what he could have achieved with our current squad. Ronaldo de Assis Moreira, aka Ronaldinho, is the living, breathing symbolism of the beautiful game. Although for a short time, it was a true honor to have him grace the red and black jersey. In the short span that he was with us, he gave us some great memories to look back at. Ronaldinho scored his first goal in the Derby della Madonnina in September 2008. He was also one of the only 5 players to receive a 10/10 rating from goal for his hat-trick against Siena. Oh, what a hat-trick that was, ladies and gentlemen. Please go back and watch it. A perceived lack of dedication in training and a lifestyle of late-night partying not befitting of an athlete saw him receive criticism with Carlo Ancelotti, his coach at Milan in the first season. Despite leaving the club in the winter of his second season, he was still eligible for a 2010-11 Serie A winner's medal as Milan's aging veterans, along with Zlatan Ibrahimovic and several others, won the Campionato. Signore, signori, this is your boy Ari, and this was a special Rossonari review of the Milan Corner. You are the reason we make this content, so please comment below and tell us what you think about these special projects and what you want from them. Lastly, please give me a like and subscribe to the channel for content like this and much more on the greatest club in the world, Associazione Calcio Milan, per sempre. Ciao tutti!